Good afternoon. We have breaking news this afternoon from the island of Kauai, where Mayor Derek Kawakami says that as of this Friday, March 20th, a nighttime curfew will go into effect on the Garden Isle. This will be every night from 9 p.m. through 5 a.m. He describes it to locals and visitors as a period where Kauai is on vacation. Just moments ago, the mayor posted this to the county's Facebook page. We realize not all viewers have access to Facebook or social media, so we're bringing you a recap of all of what the mayor said just a short time ago about curfews to be coming to Kauai as of Friday night.
Aloha, Kauai. Here's our daily COVID-19 briefing for Wednesday, March 18th. On Kauai, we currently have two positive cases of COVID-19 on island. The adult couple remains in isolation at a remote facility and both remain in stable condition. Statewide, we now have 16 total positive cases across the state. We continue to be under a national emergency per the president. The Center for Disease Control updates its website regularly with detailed guidance related to COVID-19. For more information, please visit coronavirus.gov. Today, I'd like to announce the beginning of a substantial change in our typical way of life as we have become accustomed to. Starting this Friday, we will be implementing mandatory nighttime curfews of 9 p.m. This decision was made with three goals in mind. One, protecting and preserving our existing resources. Two, managing the spread of COVID-19 by increasing social distancing, and three, ensuring that essential services, operations, and family care can continue. After taking an assessment of what will likely be a very long journey for all of us and the amount of limited resources that we have, specifically public safety, first responders, and healthcare workers, I've made the decision that in order to ensure that the public is properly protected, it is prudent that we take bold steps to ensure that our public safety officials, first responders, and healthcare workers have the necessary environment in which to keep us all safe. We realize that many people will be working, transporting goods and services, caring for family members, and other activities that contribute to a productive society outside of these curfew hours. We also realize that as visitors continue to arrive, we must now take these measures to hopefully add another layer of protection against this virus. I want to make it clear, as mayor, I realize that many of our residents need to travel for health and medical reasons. But until further notice, visitors should not be traveling to our island for recreational purposes. Kauai is on vacation. I would also like to remind everyone that marketing our island as a place to visit during this time where the president, the governor, and all four county mayors have proclaimed the time of emergency is unacceptable, insensitive, and shows no regard to the health and safety of our kupuna and for those that are most vulnerable. The longer that it takes us to make these drastic decisions, the longer it takes us to get to a point of economic recovery. We are very concerned about the many businesses and their employees that are suffering, but I'm afraid that as long as visitors continue to come here, we'll be challenged as a community to flatten the curve. I've asked Kauai Chamber of Commerce President Mark Periolo to be here to provide some resources to assist our business community. Mark?
Thank you, Mayor. Thank you again for inviting the Chamber to be with you today. We understand what a difficult decision this must be for you and your administration, but we understand why you have made this decision. It's to protect the health and safety of our residents, and that has to be first and foremost. And so for the Chamber of Commerce, I just want to say that we are here. We understand how difficult this is going to be for the business community, for the residents of Kauai, and we are here to help. And so I want to point you in the direction of some resources that are available to you in the business community and in general. First and foremost, the U.S. Chamber of Commerce has great resources on how you can work through this crisis. And so if you go to uschamber.org/coronavirus, you will see a number of great tools that you can work through in your business. Second, We are going to have a webinar on Friday. The mayor is participating if he's available, along with Senator Kochi, Jimmy Tokioka. We'll have attorneys on hand, public health officials, as well as people from the IT community, where they can answer your questions about telecommuting, how to keep your employees safe and healthy, how the state and county are responding, as well as the impacts on tourism. And so go to the Chamber's Facebook page, Kauai Chamber's Facebook page, for more information. And last but not least, we are working very actively with the Small Business Administration and the governor to make the $250 billion of emergency relief funds available to small businesses here in Kauai and throughout the state. And so look for more information for that on our social media as well. Thank you, Mayor.
Thank you, Mark. We're all in this together. And I want to stress that we'll continue to provide guidance on how we can assist our businesses and workers during this difficult time. Our highest priority at this time is to preserve and protect our residents. At this time, I'd like to turn it over to Kauai Police Department Chief Raybuck and AMR Supervisor Cody Bonilla to talk about this new curfew.
Thank you, Mayor. A nighttime curfew will go into effect starting Friday, March 20th, from the hours of 9 p.m. until 5 a.m. until further notice. Every individual within the County of Kauai must remain in their place of residence, vacation rental, or hotel room during these hours. Those in our houseless community will be allowed to shelter in place and urged not to move about during these hours.
There are exceptions to the rule. If you or your loved one is needing medical attention, do not hesitate to bring them to seek medical care during these hours. You should feel free to drive without penalty. It is not necessary to call 911 to comply with the curfew.
Also, those commuting to and from work, working for an essential service provider, namely a government entity, a public utility, or medical service whose shifts are within the curfew window, and those persons working at food service establishments having delivery services are exempt as well.
Thank you, Chief. Thank you, Cody, again. The decision to begin a curfew was not done lightly, but I believe it's in the best interest of keeping everyone safe. The rule setting the curfew is available on the Emergency Management website at www.kauai.gov/kima. And lastly, again, we're going to keep saying this over and over because it's important for everyone. Refrain from attending large public events. Remember, the CDC is now recommending that we refrain from social gatherings for groups of 10 or more. If you must interact with people in your daily life, keep a distance of 6 feet of separation. Stay home if you're sick. Keep your children home if they are sick. Limit your public outings to essential needs only and wash your hands frequently. That's your COVID-19 update for today. From our team here on Kauai, we're simultaneously reporting on our severe weather conditions. Please keep updated here on our Facebook page or on our Kima page at www.kauai.gov/kima. Thank you.
Again, that is Kauai Mayor Derek Kawakami amid a day full of rain and thunderstorms for them, coming out to tell people that as of Friday, March 20th, the Garden Isle will have nightly curfews to help prevent the spread of COVID. What does this mean? It means that everyone should be to their home, their vacation rental, to their hotel room. Even, the mayor said, for those who are houseless to remain in the area at which they are staying, even if it is outside, to remain in the one place that they have found to stay. As of March 20th, these hours for curfew on Kauai will be 9 p.m. through 5 a.m. There are some exceptions to this rule. People who are commuting to and from mandatory work, those working for an essential service provider, anyone delivering with delivery services associated with food delivery to get to people's homes, and anyone seeking medical attention, they said, should drive and get it. Again, this applies to all residents, all visitors, regardless of if they're in a hotel or a B&B, and anyone as well who is houseless. The mayor further calling upon the vacation and hospitality industries not to market Kauai as a vacation destination at this time. He said, let people know It's Kauai's turn for a vacation. Kauai, he says, is on vacation. We have the rest of that you can replay live on our Facebook, also on the Kauai County website and our website, khon2.com. In other news today, we do have an update from the state. There are now 16 cases as of midday today. Two new cases are on Oahu. Both of these, we are told by the Department of Health, are local residents who are travel-related, tested by a private lab. These are two Oahu adults who are residents here, but they have been determined to have a travel-related case. Not yet clear if they were, if these are a pair who are in the same household, and we will be getting more information for our newscasts. Also new today, public school kids K through 12 for the Hawaii Department of Education have had another week added to their spring break. The Hawaii Department of Education will close its offices except for essential functions effective tomorrow, Thursday, the March 19th. Schools will close March 30th following the current extension of spring break. Employee return dates will be staggered. Students are anticipated to return to school April 7th. So again, for school children at home, grades K through 12 for the Hawaii DOE, the return date is now April 7th. The department will be meeting internally with stakeholders, and they will be having a press conference with more details about this tomorrow. When employees do return, this will be staggered. And we do not have the details given to us yet from the Department of Education about what that means for each type of employee. But kids will be coming back on the 7th. Employees' return will be staggered sometime before that. Also today, University of Hawaii announcing it will be finishing the school year at all campuses online. University of Hawaii will not be coming back for the most part after the spring break here. There are will be some exceptions granted for in-person instruction, very limited, however. All other instruction will finish online for the whole semester. University of Hawaii libraries will be closed to the public. Social distancing will be maximized. Cleaning and disinfection will continue on buildings that are still open and will focus on buildings that are being used by any students and staff on property. Dining services for people living and working up there will be replaced with to-go or grab-and-go or delivery only. So the food will not be in the traditional dining setup. Most non-essential travel for UH has been canceled. All public events will be canceled at least through the end of April. And employees are told to expect more remote working guidance coming later today. Please do join us. We're expecting a 3 p.m. news conference today with Honolulu's Mayor Kirk Caldwell to provide updates about new steps the Honolulu County is taking. We'll have a wrap-up of all of the day's news as it comes later. Please stay with us and stay safe.